fuck happened?
What's going on, everybody? This is Trend Kill Radio, a rock news show about all things rock, except for when it's not. Brought to you by the Foundry Concert Club right here in Cleveland, Ohio. I was just there tonight getting some tacos. I am your host, Sean Ryan.
And I was mid-drink, but I'm Coley Colgate.
He sure is, everybody. There's very little news going on in the rock world right now, but there is something. And I want to preface this by saying, you know, here in America, we throw around the word oppression a lot.
Yes,
and
we
it's
do.
Always for something so fucking stupid. Like, how dare you make me wear a mask inside of the Walmart? You know, I need to get my hair cut at my local barber salon, whatever the fuck. And people just complain here in America, but we don't know how good we have it, because there is a new story about Behemoth, the band from Poland.
Mm-hmm.
Adam Nergal-Darski.
Nergal-Darski.
What's that?
I just said Nergal-Darski. It's a funny word to say.
Funny.
No, it's not.
Sure it is. It's funny.
He is in some shit right now in Poland, his native land. He is a death metal. I hope that's right. Death metal. Like,
you're gonna get
he
dragged.
Looks.
I would say death metal, sort of, maybe even some elements of black metal in there a little. But
something like that, where you paint your face all white and you got black shit all over it.
They're not true black metal musically, but they definitely look the part.
Well, this guy is fucked because he has been convicted of, quote, offending religious feelings in his home country of Poland. The charges stemmed from a 2019 incident where he had a picture on Instagram where he is stomping on a painting of the Virgin Mary.
Oh, wow.
And that offended four, count them, four people.
The number of the day is four.
Here's the question. Now, you said convicted. That means that not only was he accused of hurting feelings, but a court of law in Poland found him guilty of that and convicted him of a crime of hurting someone's feelings by bashing their assumed religion, correct? Is that just to make
yes.
sure everyone's on the same page? What and but it's so bad here in this country. Can you imagine getting, you know, convicted in this country just for hurting someone's feeling? We would all be in prison. I know I would be. I mean, maybe we're almost there in this country. I don't know. I hope not. But man, sucks to be this guy.
It is ridiculous. It sounds ridiculous. It's crazy because we supposedly have a separation of church and state.
Right.
But we're not going to get into that. Don't worry about it. It's not a religious show, political show, or whatever. We're just trying to state the facts and make some jokes. So
yeah.
No one fucking, you know, lose your mind over everything. This is all the way out in Poland, my native land.
Right, yeah.
But yeah, he's been in some trouble before. About 10 years ago, he was ripping up the Bible, which, I mean, I'm sorry to bring up Manson, but Manson did that. I mean,
for years, yeah.
Fucking 96, he was doing
that.
That was
like part of his show.
Yeah, that was like his thing. Yeah, he got in trouble for that. And then Nergal also got in trouble for having a t-shirt made with the Polish flag. And there was something kind of derogatory about it. I saw it. It looked like a really like metal version of the Polish flag. So it was like, what are you guys even fucking crying about? Whatever. I mean, here in America, I mean, you will have the American flag in a G-string up some fat white girl's ass. Like, you know, and that's totally okay if you're in Alabama.
Come on, you're gonna cut this, but I told you not to talk about my girlfriend on the show. Make sure you cut that.
I'm not cutting that. According to notes from Poland, Nergal was ordered to pay a fine of $4,000 in court costs, and he's going to fight it. And now, from what I'm gathering, this has made things so much worse, and now they're taking it to trial. And it's going to be a lengthy, big pain in the ass for this fucking guy that is just like, you know, he's very pro-choice, pro-religion, all this kind of stuff. Apparently in Poland, which I thought like most of Europe was all like, you know, free thinking and, you know, like ahead of the times. This is some medieval shit. Like this
is definitely is.
Yeah, this is dark ages, like dumb crap.
I mean, I think, you know, a lot of black metal bands, they have a stigma of being very anti-religious, burning churches and things like that, and maybe that's just kind of a harken back to that time when, you know, that used to happen regularly in the 80s and 90s, you know, in the 70s, and maybe they're just saying, hey, you're gonna pay for all the things that bands and people like you did in the past, or something to that effect. I just don't understand who cares that much. Like,
four
who,
people do.
Yeah, but in what position of power are they in that they are able to care that much and then are able to do something about it? That's crazy. Is there a situation here where this guy's going to end up in jail because of this?
I doubt it, because despite him pissing off so many people, this band, Behemoth, is pretty big. I mean, and like, now you may think like, what kind of artists, what kind of musicians have that much say? Like, in America, you would think like Jay-Z and Kanye and Taylor Swift and shit like that. But I mean, like out in Europe, I mean, like countries like Sweden and Norway and all that kind of stuff, like they do still have like rock stars.
Yeah.
And like metal bands that you would hear a metal band from there here. And yeah. Just go like, what? Are you fucking kidding me? It's like, no. They have like real rock stars still out there. Like it was like 1986.
There's so many bands from America that don't do well here, but do incredible overseas because of that reason. There's still an audience there for rock music. And we've talked about that on the show here that, you know, there's just not that audience here that much anymore. I mean, it exists, but not to the extent it used to. Yeah. So, I mean, this is a huge story there. Here, nobody's really talking about it except us. But I think it's kind of a sign of, could be a sign of things to come in all regards of just opinion and platform. It's kind of scary.
Yes, it says here that Nergal made a Virgin Mary post, a conservative legal group, Ordo Luris, an organization known to, I'm not even going to try and pronounce that, but it means Patriotic Society, notified authorities that Nergal had, quote, offended the religious feelings of four people, including a politician from Poland's ruling conservative coalition. So that's where it starts.
He pissed off the wrong guy. That's the gist of it. He pissed off the one guy who could do something about it, and he's doing something about it. That's crazy. But also, this is probably stellar for them as far as publicity goes. I mean, it doesn't get much bigger than this kind of controversy when you're a black metal band, so that's pretty cool.
Yeah, so I mean that's about it. That's all, like, you know, there's a lot of like technical jargon and stuff and citing court documents and blah 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 that really no one cares about. The basic gist of it is that he offended some people with religious outrage, and he has been fined about $5,000, and now he's going to fight it, and he's facing up to 2 years in prison for it. But he is famous, so I don't know if it's like here in America where, like, if you're famous, you can pretty much get away with a lot of stuff.
True, but we don't make examples of people here anymore. They still do that overseas, so certainly possible that he could get the book thrown at him, and not just the one that he, you know, desecrated.
Well, we'll end on that note. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please be sure to subscribe. Hit your notifications, because we don't know when these shows come out anymore. Hit us up at Facebook and Instagram at Trendkill Radio 216. And I am Sean Ryan.
And I'm Coley Colgate.
This has been Trendkill Radio.